We all know that as kids, your face is stuffed full of baby teeth that eventually fall out of your head. What's that all about? Why do we lose our baby teeth? Let's find out on today's episode of
Colossal Questions.
Our first set of teeth, which we call our baby teeth, started growing while you were still inside your mom's belly. Even though babies are born with nothing but gums showing, turns out the teeth are already there, waiting to poke their way out. Once a baby is about 6 months old, the first teeth start to show. It can be painful, but it's necessary. We need our teeth to bite and mash up our food. That's why babies just drink milk and eat formula until they have big enough teeth to chew. Most people have 20 baby teeth, 8 incisors in the front of the mouth that help you bite, 4 pointy canine teeth to tear food apart, and 8 molars in the back of the mouth that help us chew things up. Around age 6, your first baby teeth might start to loosen and fall out, and brand new teeth might start popping through the gums in the back of the mouth. By around age 12, most kids have lost all their baby teeth. That's around the age that your jaw grows big enough to support some grown-up teeth, and a few more of them too. When our 20 baby teeth fall out, they're replaced by 32 new adult teeth. There are still just 8 incisors and 4 canine teeth, but 4 more molars, giving us 12. Adults also have 8 extra premolars, which makes for a much bigger mouthful of teeth. Okay, so we replace our little baby teeth with bigger teeth as our mouth and jaw grow. Makes sense, but how does it work? Why do teeth become loose and fall out of our mouths? Well, that's because our teeth are held in place by roots, much like how a tree stays firmly in the ground. Those roots keep our teeth firmly in place, but they're also why we lose them when the time is right. You see, as your new permanent adult tooth forms, it pushes on the roots of the baby tooth and slowly dissolves them using special bone cells called odontoclasts that absorb the old roots into the new forming tooth. When those baby teeth roots get short and weak enough, the tooth starts to loosen and wobble and eventually break off and fall out. Before long, the adult tooth will poke through the gums in the gap left by the baby tooth. Those new adult teeth have much stronger and much longer roots than their baby counterparts, since they're never meant to leave your mouth. Now, whether or not they do might come down to how well you treat them, but that's a whole other episode. Kids do a lot of growing, but have you ever wondered why adults don't keep growing too? Let's find out on today's episode of
Colossal Questions.
The main reason we stop growing is because our DNA tells us to. Let me explain. Every person starts as one single cell. That cell splits and splits and splits millions of times more. And before you know it, that cluster of cells is a complex structure. When you're born, you continue to grow and develop quickly until the end of puberty, when your DNA finally tells your body to stop growing. Once you finally leave puberty, your body starts producing lots of estrogen, which is a hormone that basically fuses shut the receptors in your bones that cause growth. So that's how your body stops growing. But why? Well, scientists aren't positive, but they do have some theories. You see, it's actually a disadvantage to be too tall. It puts a lot of stress on your bones and muscles, which can lead to arthritis and trouble moving. It also makes it much harder on your organs, because your heart needs to pump much harder to get blood all around such a big body. So, would it be fun to just keep growing until we were all giants? Well, sure, but just be glad we don't get so tall that it's hard to live. One of the telltale signs that someone's over the hill is when their hair turns gray. But why? What causes your hair to go white as we age? Let's find out on today's episode of
Colossal Questions.
Every human hair has two parts, a shaft and a root. The shaft is mostly what we see when we think of hair, the long, colorful part that grows out of our head. The root is the part that keeps the hair attached. The root of every single hair stays stuck to your scalp by squeezing it into a little sac called a follicle. These follicles produce a special kind of chemical called melanin, which is what determines the color of our hair, eyes, and skin. The more melanin you have, the darker the hair, eyes, or skin. As we get older, the special cells in our hair follicles begin to die. Since those are the cells that give your hair its color, the follicle starts pumping out hairs without any color, one by one. Okay, so that's why your hair goes white, but is there anything you can do when you're young to prevent it? Nope. Some people start getting gray hairs young, and others take some time, but eventually everyone will get some gray hair. The best way to gauge how your hair will fare when you're older is to look at your parents and other older family members. How your hair ages is determined by genetics, meaning your parents pass it down to you, so chances are your hair will look like one of your parents by the time you grow up. You probably know that exercising helps your muscles grow big and strong, but have you ever wondered how they actually grow? Let's find out on today's episode of
Colossal Questions.
Each person has more than 600 different muscles in their body that help you do just about everything. Carry things, walk, talk, hold your head up, and even pump blood and oxygen through your body. A muscle might look like one solid mass of meat, but it's actually made up of thousands and thousands of small rubber band-like fibers. There are three different types of muscles inside your body. Smooth muscles are thin, layered muscles you can't control, found in places like your throat, bladder, and eyes. Cardiac muscles control your heartbeat and are designed to help you pump blood through your heart, and like smooth muscles, they work all on their own. The kind of muscles you're probably picturing are called skeletal muscles. These are the ones that you control. Arms, legs, neck, anything that helps you move your bones around. So that's the different types of muscles, but how do they actually grow? To answer that, we'll have to take another look at the tiny fibers that, together, make up your muscles. Whenever you exercise, like going for a walk, lifting weights, or playing sports, those muscle fibers get stressed and damaged with little microscopic tears. That might sound like bad news, but that tearing is what helps your muscles grow big. Your body hops into action to repair the torn areas so they grow even bigger and stronger than before. When the body repairs each tear, it leaves the area slightly thicker and stronger than before. So the more of those little tears you get, the thicker and stronger your muscles grow. That's why getting exercise is so important. Your muscles won't just grow strong on their own. If you aren't willing to push them out of their comfort zone from time to time, they'll start to shrivel and weaken. That doesn't mean you need to become a bodybuilder to stay healthy, but simple activities like walking, biking, and playing games goes a long way to keeping your muscles healthy, no matter how old you are. Today, we're tackling the creepiest and maybe the most massive question there is. What happens after you die? Let's find out on today's episode of
Colossal Questions.
Now, we won't be talking about what happens to your soul. That's way too colossal a question to answer in a 2-minute YouTube video, but we can say what happens to the body. In the first few seconds after death, brain activity spikes and then stops completely. Body temperature, which usually hovers around 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit, will start dropping by 1.5 degrees Fahrenheit every hour until it reaches room temperature. Within just a few minutes, cells start to break down because they're no longer receiving oxygen from the lungs. After just a few hours, the calcium in the body starts to collect in the muscles, making them stiff. After about a day and a half, the muscles will relax again. In just a few weeks, hair starts falling out, and all sorts of little bugs eat over half of the body. After several months, depending on the temperature, everything will completely decompose until just a skeleton is left. Kinda spooky. Okay, wait. So if a body becomes a skeleton after just a few months, how do archaeologists find mummies and preserve people from thousands of years ago? That's a good question, me. Well, for starters, most of the time, bones are what archaeologists dig up. Bodies that stay preserved that long are way more rare and go by a name you've probably heard, mummies. A mummy is a dead person or animal whose body is preserved intentionally or unintentionally long after their death. Most people can picture a mummy that was made on purpose, but sometimes it can happen accidentally. For example, there are chemicals in peat bogs that can almost perfectly preserve bodies for hundreds or even thousands of years. Extremely dry places like deserts can also keep a body mummified naturally, as can extreme cold. Probably the most famous example of a spontaneous mummy is Ötzi. Also known as the Iceman, Ötzi is an extremely well-preserved natural mummy of a man who lived and died more than 5,000 years ago. His body was found on an icy mountain range in 1991, completely encased in ice. He's the oldest known natural mummy in Europe, and since being found, has helped scientists discover tons of new information about what it was like to live thousands of years ago. Now that's just about as cool as ice! Or maybe I just have the chills from all this death talk.